Hello. So today we are going to look at the Casio fx-260 solar scientific calculator. And I'm going to show you how to use the fraction buttons to add, subtract, like to do fraction calculations, both with mixed numbers and improper fractions, and to toggle between fractional form and decimal form so that you can kind of look at all representations of the same number. So right here, calculator's on. This button right here looks like a mixed number. This is how you enter fractions. So clicking this will basically add in a separation of between, if you're just doing a fraction like 2/3, let's just write that down here. You're going to enter it as 2. And then you're going to hit this fraction bar. And so notice that creates the dividing bar between the 2 and the 3. So 2 numerator, and here is now the denominator. So that's what the fraction looks like in the calculator. It's because it's in linear mode, so it's not standard form, so it doesn't look like a fraction. So that is the division symbol or dividing between the 2. And now if I wanted to do a calculation, so let's say I wanted to add 5/7 to that, I'm going to use my normal addition, so add. But now I'm going to enter this fraction, 5/7. So I enter the 5, the numerator first, hit that fraction button to show that we're entering a fraction, and then sevenths. And when I hit equal, notice my answer is in fractional form, and it has 3 instead of 2, and that's because this is now a mixed number. So really the way to read this is that's the whole, and this is the fractional part. So the answer to this is 1/8/21. Now you can toggle, and what would that be as an improper? So above this button in yellow, it has a D/C, which is it's going to convert it into its improper form. So if I hit shift, because it's in yellow, and then this button, it'll take that answer and show me what it is in improper fractional form. So that's what it is. And I can also, let's go back, if I toggle again, I will get the decimal equivalent of that. So this button, once you have your solution, you can toggle between them and look at all different representations of that same solution. So that's a nice exploration for students. So how do you actually enter something that is a mixed number? So let's say I want to enter 3/1/5, and I want to subtract 4/2/7. I like sevenths. So I'm just doing regular calculations here, but I'm going to enter the whole number and the fraction as in between. I'm going to use this button each time. So the 3 wholes, and then I'm going to enter the fraction button, and that shows the whole. And now I'm going to enter the fractional part, the 1/5. So whole and fractional part, that's what it looks like. And now I'm going to subtract, and we're going to subtract 4. There's the whole, so I have to hit this button to separate. And then my fractional part is 2/7. And then when I hit equals, I should see my answer. And notice my answer is a negative. So my answer here is -1/3/35. And if I hit that button again, I see the decimal version of that. So -1.09 if we're going to round. And then if I hit the shift and that button, I see the improper fraction of that, -38/35. So nice little applications of all those. And it does multiplication, division, all of the things you would expect. And that's how you use the fraction button and toggle between mixed, whole, mixed, improper, and decimal.